to make Persian Barbari bread. The ingredients include white bread flour, whole wheat flour, active dry yeast, sugar, and sea salt. We also use some seeds, sesame seeds and black nigella seeds if you have them. Otherwise, chia seeds also work. Sometimes I'll even use hemp seeds, any kind of seed really. The first step is to activate the dry yeast. Put it in a small bowl, empty the packet of active dry yeast. Next, you're going to add in 1 teaspoon of sugar and 1/3 cup of warm water. Now you're just going to stir that around nice and combined. And then once you've done that, go ahead and cover it. Sometimes I'll cover it with plastic wrap first and then a cloth and allow that to sit. While that is sitting for 30 minutes, go ahead and put in flour. You're actually going to need 3 cups, not 2, I think I only put 2 in this video, but actually 3 cups of white flour, bread flour if you have it, and 1 cup of whole wheat flour. And then what you're going to want to do is just go ahead and also add 1 tablespoon of sugar in with the flours and 1 tablespoon of sea salt. Use your hands now and go ahead and just combine that with your hands till it's all nice and combined. We're going to work with our hands quite a bit in this recipe. I find it to be really nice. Now, next, we're going to collect water. Let's check our active yeast here. Ooh, that's ready. When it's puffed up and bubbly after about 30 minutes, go ahead and add it to the flour mixture. I'll just use a spoon and add it in and then go ahead and combine it with water. So you're going to have a total of 1.5 cups of warm water. I'll typically put in 1 cup to start and start kneading it with my hands. This is a sticky dough, and I want you to know that it's supposed to be sticky. Just keep squeezing it and squeezing it and kneading it and working the water in. This is called a high hydration bread, and so therefore the dough is going to be extremely sticky, but be patient with it. Keep squeezing, keep working, turning it over and working it in. Now, I typically do this part, the hand kneading, for about 30 to 40 minutes. Every time your dough starts to absorb the water and start to kind of become dry, that's when you know it's time to add a little bit more water. So with the remaining water, so now it's a total of 1.5 cups that you're adding to your flours. With the remaining water, after that first 1 cup that you've already been kneading in, just go ahead and you can see here, it's starting to get worked in and dry. Go ahead and add a little bit more water in gradually. So I like to kind of fold over the dough, squeeze it, turn it, fold it over. That's how I knead. Get it off my fingers. Yeah, so go ahead and fold it, squeeze it, turn it. And once it's become dry like this, that's when I definitely will start to add a little bit more water gradually, like maybe like 1/8 or 1/4 cup at a time. Continue to add more water and work it in. I actually really like this process. I find it to be kind of therapeutic. So believe it or not, all the water gets worked in. Eventually, all the water gets nice and absorbed. And the result is going to be, once you've been kneading by hand like this for a full, I would say, takes me 40 minutes, it will, when you know it's kind of done with this, it'll be sticking to the bottom, but not sticking sticking to your hands as much, and when it starts to stick to the bottom, but not to your hands as much, that's when you know you've done your work. And you can just make a nice little ball and cover it. Cover it with a cute little dishcloth and let her rise. This part, go do something. You know, today I had a massage. Let it sit minimum of 1 hour. If you could let it sit for 3 or 4 hours, even better. Now you're going to take it out and lightly flour a surface that you'll be working on, as well as your ball of dough. And now we're going to go ahead and make this ball into 3 somewhat equal parts. And now we'll kind of knead it a little bit more. I don't always. If I've let it sit for 2 or 3 hours and it's risen a good amount, I'll just go ahead and work with those 3 balls right away. But on this particular day, I think I had only let it rise for 1 hour. So I am working these balls again and actually going to shape them and cover them again for a second rise. So there's a couple ways you can do it. Here we go. And now I'm ready to shape it. Sometimes I'll kind of like let it stretch with a gravity. Other times I'll use my hands. But basically the shape of Barbari should be like a long oval. And then traditionally what you do is you'll make these long, you know, sort of like on the vertical stripes with your fingers. That's how it's traditionally done. Then it's a couple of different ways. You can either do an egg wash or olive oil. So sometimes I'll just use olive oil, kind of like how you would do focaccia. I'll either use a spray bottle or I'll brush it on. And then put your seeds on, sesame seeds. This day I use chia. Sprinkle them on, and then you're going to put it into a preheated oven. Your oven will be heated to 450 degrees Fahrenheit. And once you've got all your seeds on there and your oven's warm, you're gonna go ahead and bake that in your oven, 450 degrees, for 15 to 18 minutes. It should be kind of lightly browned on the top. Look at that, it looks so good. It smells amazing. I take 2 baking sheets to make 3 small Barbari loaves. Now the way to traditionally cut these loaves is to simply cut them now on the horizontal, cut them across into like little strips. Oh, this is a fluffy, light bread, and that's due to that being high hydration. And you can see the little air holes inside. You know you've done a good job. Mmm, delicious. I love eating this with butter. It can be enjoyed for breakfast, as an appetizer, or just about any time of day. This is absolutely one of my all-time favorite Persian breads. Mmm, delicious. I hope you've enjoyed this recipe. I'm showing you another day, this particular day when I covered it, I allowed it to sit and rise for 4 hours and it got much bigger. And so therefore I did not have to do the second rise on this day. I went ahead and took my dough and divided it into the 3 parts. I'm just kind of showing you 2 methods here. And once I got it into the 3 parts, I didn't need to like let it rise again. I didn't even like really knead it anymore after that. This was a good dough. I had worked all the water in and I have gone and gotten a massage, and so it's pretty much good to go. I thought I would need to let it rise, but when I checked on it a few minutes, I'm like, you know what, this is good to go. So I went ahead and just shaped it. I shaped it. This day I did both sort of pressing and letting gravity stretch it a little bit. So just kind of showing you the second time I made it. And yeah, so definitely just kind of like let the air gravity stretch it. And then I also do sort of shape it with my hands as well. If you've got a lightly floured surface, you should be able to manipulate it both on the surface as well as kind of when you're holding it up and letting it stretch. So I sort of do a combination of both ways. And I learned how to do this from, you know, a very traditional Iranian pastry chef and sort of the old-fashioned method. I do love working with my hands. I have a stand mixer. I do have like a stand mixer and I could use it, but I really like making bread with my hands. I just love it, actually. It's not hard at all. It's good for your hands. It's good for your upper body. It's good for your mind. And let me tell you, it's good for your belly because it's delicious. So yeah, you get the basic gist of it. Kind of got two videos in one here. And each time I make it, you know, I learn something. And this particular time, I used the two different top wash methods described in my recipe. Went ahead and made my long vertical stripes with my fingers. I use parchment lined baking sheet. So the oven is preheating to 450. I go ahead and do my stripies with my fingers, like my ancient ancestors used to do. I don't go for perfect here, you guys. I mean, this is a rustic bread. There's no perfect in rustic bread. Especially if you're doing these little prints. It doesn't have to be perfect. All right, and so I do use an egg wash in this example. And I just use one egg and one tablespoon of water. And I whisk that together. And then I use a pastry brush to coat the entire surface of the bread. Now, this does two things. It will help the top of the bread to brown, and it will also help those seeds to stick on. So either do it that way, as I'm demonstrating here. This day I use chia seeds and hemp seeds. I didn't have sesame seeds this day, but doesn't matter. Seeds are seeds, in my opinion. It doesn't really affect the flavor that much to me. I also went ahead for the third one and used olive oil. I love olive oil and I love the flavor of it. And to me, it makes like a rustic, more like almost like focaccia type topping. And it also helps that, you know, help the seeds to stick on while cooking and baking. Voila, beautiful Persian Barbari bread. You guys, delicious. So this is the egg wash one and it's cooling. When you see those holes, you know this is a good bread. This is a light and fluffy, delicious bread. I hope you enjoyed it.